Guys, welcome to PC Drills, where I find help on how to handle your PC related issues. Today we'll be demonstrating to you how you can convert a Word document to a PDF format. So after typing your Word documents you wish to print, you don't want your document to be modified when you want to print it. For example, you type it on Word 2016 and going to print somewhere that they're using but Word 2012, or you type with Word 2012 or 2013 instead and you wish to go and print it where they are using but a different version. So any version that you type with Word, to change it to another version, there's usually some modifications. Maybe the tabs, some are giving much more space, maybe some links that you added, they are shifted, some things are moved to the next line. All those things, to avoid it, you need to change your document to the PDF format. So that's what we are explaining to you today, how you can convert it. It's very simple, it's a very simple process. So you just have to have your document typed. So what I have to do here is the document I wish to convert. It's just 8 pages. All I have to do is go to File, and then I have to click on Export. So this is how you do it on Word 2016 upward. So for other versions of Word that are less than 2016, some you have to click on File. When you click on File, you have to go to Print for some. That's how you have to do. You go to Print. When you go to Print on those other versions, you'll see something like Print to PDF. So for the type of printer, you have to choose but Print to PDF. That's how you do it on other versions. Even on this version, it's still there, you can print to PDF. But the simpler way is just to click on Export. You just have to click here, Export, and then you click Create PDF/XPS document. You can click here or you can click here, both do the same thing. So if I click on it, I'm going to be shown with this window. It will say the name of the file I wish to save after it has been changed to PDF. I can modify it and even add PDF to the end, so that when I'll be doing or sharing, I'll easily identify it. So I choose the location where I wish to save it. Let's just say I wish to save it to the downloads. Allow this open file after publishing, so that when I create it, I'll easily see the file and check if there are any things that are not good or have been mishandled with the document. So this is where the file gets saved. So I have to click on Publish. When I publish, it will do the job and open up with my PDF reader. So one thing to note about converting documents to PDF is when there are images in the document, the image gets compressed. So sometimes it loses its quality. So if you're having high quality images, it's just good for you to work it and then you allow it in the Word format. You can even connect the printer with the machine you use in typing. So that's just something you should keep in mind. So if the image quality, you don't really need it to be in HD like the snapped photo that you used, no issue, and just convert it to PDF. But if it's just text like this one, there's no issue with what we have done. So that's just how to convert your document to PDF. So for example, let's say we wish to take the document now from PDF and convert it back to Word. So let me show you how easy that can be. So we first of all explain how to convert from Word to PDF. Now to convert from PDF to Word, the thing is simple. You simply have to right click on a Word document and then you go to Open With. Once in Open With, you need to find out if you can see Word among the options that have been shown here. Right now we cannot see Word, so you can click here, choose another app and look for where Word is on your own machine. But since it's not being displayed here, let's go through the other simpler method. To do it, I'll simply have to open up Word. This is a document that I converted at first. To open up the PDF, I'll instead have to go to File. and then I'll go to open. When I go to open, I'll have to go to this PC and then I browse to find out where that document was. The document, I saved it in the downloads folder. So this is the PDF I wish to open. So I have to double click on it, or I click once and then I open. Both do the same thing. So when I click on it, it's going to convert it to Word format and then open it. That's how easy it can be. So when you see this notification, Word will now convert your PDF to an editable. This is, you just have to click OK. Because to open it in Word, you need to be in Word format. That's what the notification says. So you convert it to Word, and then now we can use it. You can edit and then remove what you need to remove and save it again. But one thing to note about converting a document from PDF to Word is that some things generally won't be the same anymore. So some minor conflicts will be encountered. So for example, with a document, we had something like here. We have on the first page, we have chapter 3. Under chapter 3, we have these points. They are represented with a square kind of dot. But here, after converting, you can see that instead of having a square kind of dot, we have a plus kind of mark that's attributed where the square was located. So those are just some minor differences that occur when you convert a document from PDF to Word, as well as when you convert to Word from Word to PDF, just images will be affected. When you convert from PDF to Word, these are some of the issues you can encounter. Some kind of arrows will be changed and some will not match well. So to solve this issue, sometimes it's just good to use a particular type of conversion or a particular application that will convert in one direction and use the same application that will convert in the other direction. So if we use Microsoft to convert and use Microsoft again to undo, it will be easy to maintain. So that's just a tip for you to keep in mind, that after converting you can have some conflicts, but at the end it's still editable. So you can come back here and then you change every single thing that you don't want it to be, and just click here and then you change from the star to the arrow. So it's not a big deal when doing stuff and they get changed by on the way. So just to keep in mind. Thank you for watching, and that was all for today. I wish it was helpful. See you next time on our next video. For any suggestions, please leave them at the comment section, or you contact us through any of our social media platforms. See you on our next video. Bye for now, and see you later.